Hello everyone, Inside Frame, how are you doing? In the last video we did Can You Beat Fallout New Vegas with Craft Equipment from a Workbench. Very interesting challenge and it took a fascinating turn. However, today we're going to go back to XCOM franchise and ask, can you beat XCOM 2 War of the Chosen with one soldier? Now, any of you who have played XCOM know that this is an absolutely brutal challenge, as XCOM is a turn-based game where you use a team of soldiers, so using a single soldier in the field will be extremely difficult, especially in the beginning of the game, as it's very harsh. However, unlike XCOM 2, this has The Chosen, a group of alien villains who act as mini-bosses to us, which will be extremely difficult to overcome. We also have tiredness as well, because soldiers have stamina, so I'm not entirely sure if it's possible to beat the game, but I think the different sit reps on each mission will help us out massively, so we'll be able to use it effectively. But with The Chosen, we'll just have to try our best. So let's quickly go over the rules. We may only reload to the mission selection screen. This means we can attempt missions as many times as we want, but we will have to reattempt them from the start and on a different map. Think of it as a soft Iron Man mode. We can only have one soldier active, excluding the first mission, of course. Operatives are allowed, but these soldiers will be strictly covert ops. If they're ambushed, they are not allowed to fight. They're only allowed to move to the evac point. No cheating or modding, no glitch or exploits, and we're going to be playing on veteran difficulty. So with all that explained, let's get started with the playthrough. We start the game on up and we go ahead and select veteran difficulty, which is this game's normal difficulty. Now, we're not Tony Stark, so no Iron Man today, thank you. We'll skip over that. We don't enable the Lost and Abandoned quest, as it has a mission where we need two squads, so that would be very awkward, so I'd rather not do that. We then get the cutscene play for War of the Chosen, which is awesome, and then we get the regular cutscene with the newsreader, but we jump straight into our first mission and we start with a Reaper. And we get to it. We set everyone up for an ambush, and Frost starts off strong with a triple kill against the aliens using an explosion. And we get everyone shooting during the ambush, and it goes absolutely flawlessly. The enemy just get torn to shreds, which is just brilliant. The officer misses his attack on Frost, which is always good. And Mr. Reaper chips the officer's health away by a good margin. We then take a risky shot, and we go ahead, and Frost hits the mark. Well done, Frost. We plant the charges and get the cutscene, completing the mission flawlessly. It's only going to get tougher from here on out, so we decide the promotions and we want the sharpshooter class, as this is the sharpshooter solo run after all. But Frost gets the promotion, taking up his rifle once more, as he is the resistance in the field now. We decide to keep the Reaper, as they can serve as our covert operative but will only be in covert ops as per the rules. So we get Alfred in a Batman situation, which is very, very good. Dr. Richard Tigan is introduced to us as our chief scientist, so the first research we assign is alien biotech to get the infirmary ASAP. Dr. Lily Shen is next. We don't really need anything, but we say hello to her nonetheless, as it's good manners. And last but not least is Bradford, who is absolutely awesome. With the crew met, we see the world map and we begin our scanning. Our research concludes, so the Advent Officer is our next research, and we immediately get to building the infirmary, as even Batman gets injured from fighting crime. We get Guerrilla Ops, which is this game's events, and we have the Lost present in this area, which are zombies that attack both sides. This is fantastic news for us, as we can use them against the aliens, so we go for it. On starting the mission, we start on top of the main road and we drop down, spotting the Lost, and decide to grenade the relay, so the sound gets all the Lost in the area running towards the alien's position. And then we retreat up a ladder and block the way, so the Lost can't get to us. With the Lost let loose, they get to do what they do best and swarm the enemy in droves. We set up for a sniper shot, but the alien sectoid, my nemesis, panics us, which isn't good. But the aliens kill a couple of the Lost, which doesn't go well for them, but then the Lost return the favour on their turn and kill the sectoid, releasing us from panic, which is great for us. We start shooting the Lost, and if you kill a Lost, they grant a free action. So we just keep killing many of the Lost, and after several turns and about 5 minutes of real life time, we just keep killing them and shoot them like a shooting gallery. And once the last of the Lost are finished, we finish the mission. Russ is out for a week but gets a promotion, so we can pick an ability. For those of you that don't know, soldiers rank up in this game and you can pick abilities which power them up. In this case, we get return fire, which allows us to use our pistol for a reaction shot once per turn. Not the best ability, but it's something to work with for sure. We then get the XCOM informant who is revealed, and we'll call him Mr. X. Mr. X is a very mysterious fellow and informs us of what's going on with the alien. The advent officer is then researched, the proving grounds is unlocked, and we get the resistance comms underway immediately. Speaking of the resistance, one of our members has a mission for us and we can't pass up the science and intel, so we go ahead. We deploy Frost and we do the usual stealth recon around the map and we find the VIP. We use the VIP to contact one of the guards, but the aliens respond and my nemesis panics Frost. He hides away in full cover, which is actually a pretty smart move, and our guard manages to get to his buddy. And on their next turn, they get out unharmed. The aliens try their damnedest to kill our scientists, which doesn't really work in their favour at all. And once in position, we evac the scientist out, leaving just Frost. We decide to backtrack and go inside the building, away from the action and out of sight. We run through many corridors, staying out of danger, and another lost swarm appears. We eventually get back in the action as we see the sectoid once more, and we try to grenade him, which damages him and draws the lost in, which is something the sectoid is not impressed with. He's quite upset, so uses a psionic attack against us, and this was absolutely nerve-wracking. We miss with return fire, which is very bad. We have to miss our turn, but Frost does run back and shoot the trooper, which is exactly what I would have done, so fair play. But the trooper decides to shoot the lost, which is fair enough. The lost encroach in on our turn, and we start running. The sectoid decides to kill a single loss unit and then targets Frost, which is not a smart move, as return fire saves our bacon. However, our friends are closing in fast and eating troopers, so we get running. On our next turn, we simply get to the evac point and mission complete. The Lost really are benefiting us this early in the game. Frost gets promoted to Sergeant and we get Lightning Hands, allowing us to get a free attack with our pistol. This is an absolute game changer as this allows us to add in extra damage, but we have to be careful as Frost is now very tired. However, we do get a bunch of rewards. We get a stroke of luck as we have a scientist thanks to a scan and our research finishes. We decide to build the resistance as the Avengers need a place to hang out after all, and we get our first retaliation mission, and whilst we don't intend to finish the mission, we can at least gain some experience from kills, so when we deploy, the plan goes south very quickly as the assassin shows up, which is the worst chosen for us to go against as they'll just close the gap and kill us. At least we get a shot on the sectoid of a sniper, they shoot back so we can scratch and dispatch. We have to go as we'll die pretty damn quickly. Legion of Doom have their meeting as they want to stop Frost Firejacket Odinson from being a hero, and these guys will mess us up if we slip up, so the real challenge starts here. The radio towers are researched, which is excellent, and a new region is contacted. The Warlock is spotted in another region, which is great, but we kind of want the Hunter. But it's not all doom and gloom, as the infirmary is up and running, along with the resistance comms. A huge boost for us, for sure. We get more Guerrilla Ops, and more of our friends, the Lost, are here to help us out, so we get boots to the ground and get the mission started. We begin moving about and stealthing around, and we spot a few of our friends. We leave them to it as they're chasing a sectoid off, and they're keeping the enemy busy by swarming them, which is simply marvellous. The objective is sighted, however, a sectoid does the usual thing and panics us, which is not part of the plan without prep time. Then it gets worse as the Legion of Doom Warlock shows up and he summons evil ghost zombies, as you do, I guess. We see the results and yeah. As for the aliens, they aren't doing so well against the Lost, bless our sort of allies, even if they do try to kill us sometimes, but they eat the aliens for breakfast. We kill a couple of the Lost in the petrol station by using our abilities and then obtain the contents of the mystery box. We decide to get up high and the Chosen decides to show up and intimidate us with a mind control. However, for once, we actually resist it, which is brilliant. So when it comes to our turn, like a true marksman, the Chosen is filled with bullet holes, with as much as we can throw at them. Once we're finished, a Lancer decides to go up for us, but it misses, which is funny as he gets shot in the face with return fire. And then the Chosen puts up a shield to protect himself. So we drop down and grenade his friends to blow a hole in the wall. And then the ghost zombie goes into the fray of the Lost, which is really not a smart move. When it's the Lost turn, our friends start eating up all of the alien forces, including the Chosen, which is beautiful. However, we haven't been the most courteous or considerate to our friends, so they're quite angry with us and they start swarming us. So we decide to evac out and get Frost back to safety. Back at base, Frost is gravely wounded with 22 days out of action, but since we got the infirmary, we staff it to half the time to 11 days. Frost, you're doing really well, man. Trust me. We established contact across North America, which is good, and we doubled down with a radio beacon so we can get the continent bonus. However, we do get a raid mission and we pass on it, so part of the area we do lose contact with, so we just have to re-establish contact. Magnetic Weapons finishes its research, giving us access to a decent damage boost. We get a breakthrough with improved snipers as well, so we get on ASAP as +1 damage as a must-have. We get a resistance mission, so we get on it and we start with the sneaky. We also go up some stairs to scout the area and we get caught, which is not good. The Sectoid even lands a hit on us and return fire props and hits for minor damage. But when it's our turn, we use lightning hands on a flame trooper and it allows us to finish it off with a grenade, making them explode, taking the trooper and the Sectoid out. And it also destroys the stairs as a bonus. Next turn, however, the Lancer tries to hit us but misses and gets returned fire in his face. We unfortunately get burnt, so we hunker down to get it to pass, but then the Lancer attacks again and misses to receive another return fire to the base, which kills him. A Viper shows up with a mech, we get to the VIP, and the Viper thankfully misses its grapple. The mech also misses, so we run as far away as physically possible. We keep running, but the Viper manages to poison us, which isn't ideal, but we make it to the evac and exit, completing the mission. We get an engineer for our troubles and some intel, which is absolutely huge for this stage of the game. Thrash is out for 8 days, but it'll be half when we staff the infirmary. It's time to build a power relay as well to help out with our power. Improved snipers is completed, adding +1 damage to our snipers. Gorilla Ops is on the agenda and we want to prevent Advent from gaining armor, so we go ahead. Also, since we still have the Reaper card, the timer won't tick down whilst we're concealed. A true lifesaver. We sell up in the loadout screen and once we're good, it's time to send Thrash off. We scout about to see if we can find a chink in the enemy's armor and we see a flame trooper with a Sectoid. We wait patiently until they are next to a high explosive barrel and we set the sucker off, causing a chain explosion, doing massive damage, which leaves my nemesis. We chance a shot with a coin flip and we get the shot off, killing him. A Sectoid and a mech say hello, but we run away for dear life and we meet a priest and a flame trooper. We hack the system and take cover for our own good. Reinforcements come in the form of a priest and a trooper, which makes things a little bit tougher. So we decide to fall back. However, as we fall back, we try and get a better position, but my old nemesis is present and decides to panic us, which is annoying as hell. But it's clear that the aliens took shooting lessons from stormtroopers as they cannot hit a fish in a barrel. I mean, come on guys, it's not that bad. You can shoot us if you want. And then we move on to the Sectoid. Once it's the aliens' turn, they really don't know what they're doing with their weapons, so we teach them a lesson by stopping the mech in its tracks. And a shielded unit attacks us, but isn't too bright as it dies to return fire. This ability is really starting to pay off. We see a flame trooper, so decide to track the priest down and shoot them. Their response is to take cover and fire at us, but we counter beautifully in return. When it's our turn, we use lightning hands to kill the priest and move far away from the flame trooper as possible, and wait for our ability to come off cooldown, so we can go and kill the second priest. When we find them, we can fill them full of lead, which also kills the flame trooper, ending our objective. Back at base, the XCOM gods smile on us as Thrust Firejacket gets a promotion and we get Quick Draw, which allows us to attack with our pistol as a free action if it's our first action, which is absolutely a huge game changer. Well done, Thrust, you are doing extremely well, good sir. The good news doesn't stop as we go to the black market and decide to get Illyrian crystals, as well as a scope, which will improve our accuracy. We also finally build a mind shield, so the Sectoids are now just useless with their mind tricks. And Gorse weaponry gets researched, so we can now get tier 2 weaponry. The power relay is up and running, which is just brilliant. But unfortunately, we have to pass on a raid mission as we're not ready to take out the assassin yet and can't really afford to. But we do contact a new region and spot the final chosen, which is the Hunter. The Resistant Ring begins construction. We also upgrade our sniper rifle for some much needed damage, and we get some covert ops going as well, as we want to find the Templar faction. After a few days, we get our covert ops come back with the Templar in tow, and Thrust has developed a bond with Alfred. We get the resistance ring up and running, and any extra personnel we have are only going to be doing covert ops, as per the rules. Gorilla Ops strikes again, but we get the ideal operation as our friends the lost are present and we can nab ourselves an engineer. It's like a fresh pie out the oven, what's not to love about it? We kit Thrust out with a scope for +5% accuracy and we quickly go to the black market to buy a superior agility with intel, as it will be very useful for later on, and we equip the mind shield as well, so we go out with our new toys to show these aliens what for. Mission begins and we very quickly run into two Sectoids, but mind shield now makes them far less dangerous. They try mind control us, it doesn't work anymore, and we can just safely let return fire proc. But we missed a second sectoid, and he decides to shoot us, and we leave the aliens to it and let the Lost deal with them as they get into a tar pit against them, which is awesome. We quickly hone in on the objective, plant the charges, and get to high ground very quickly. The sectoid tries to show he's still a nemesis, but he has been demoted to a sidekick as we return fire for 4 damage. The sectoid still tries to mind control us, only to get shot in the process, which is hilarious. The Lost do their thing of being meat shields against the aliens, which is always good. The aliens move around and we kill one of their own outright, and we move over to hide when an advent mech tries to catch us up. But we finish the mech off and we decide to hide in a shipping container. We agree to buy a Mouton who shoots and misses like a true stormtrooper, and when it's our turn we use everything in our toolkit, but we don't manage to kill the Mouton, he survives on 2 HP. So when the Mouton misses and a random Lancer comes in, he misses as well. So we kill the Lancer as well as the Mouton, and then we spot a flame trooper walking on by. We hit them with an Overwatch shot, and then we have a lot of fun as we kill the flame trooper and they explode. Frost hits the ground with all the fun and takes damage, but gets a random trooper saying hello. So hello, random trooper. But this random trooper has had stormtrooper training and fails to hit Frost. We then use our superior training to hit him to show him how it's done, which ends the mission. Once back at base, Captain Frost has earned a promotion and we get Face Off, a devastating ability that allows us to hit all targets that we can see. A decent ability for sure that can do a lot of damage in the right situation. We get a truckload of loot and an engineer for our troubles. We put them in the infirmary so Frost is out for 8 days. The proving grounds is completed and looking great. We also get another engineer off the world map from a scan, which is just so nice. A supply raid mission comes our way, which will help hugely, so we upgrade Frost's rifle with a free reload. We get cracking and we have to be extremely careful this mission as we don't have our lost friends this time. So we start the mission on up and the Chosen shut, which isn't too bad as they're more of an area denial specialist. We find our first group of enemies and we manage to use Lightning Hands and Face Off to deal with them. The Hunter shows us his ability of making us constantly move all the time whilst trying to avoid taking damage. We do get some damage as we move, but return fire isn't hitting a thing today as the enemies are trying to kill us. We do eventually use Lightning Hands to do some damage and the mech decides to suppress us, but finally, return fire hits something and gets us a confirmed kill, thank goodness. We keep moving, staying out of the Hunter's marked area and chipping away at the shield bearer, and we eventually kill them. We sneak around the map and we eventually get to a turret near the Chosen and it opens fire at us. We deal 1 HP of damage to it, but our sniper one-shots it. The Chosen comes into view and we use our sniper shot to deal as much damage as we can. The Hunter isn't too chuffed at us and summons reinforcements, which isn't good. And then he tries to trank shot us, but Mind Shield blocks the dazed status. And we also use Face Off to devastate everyone, and the aliens do their thing of missing the shots like the silly billies they are, and we use our counter to kill one of the troops, most excellent. The second trooper is ended with a pistol shot, leaving us the Hunter. We snipe the Hunter for decent damage, but he tries to trank shot us, doing nothing. Much like the Chosen Warlock before him, we fill the Hunter full of bullet holes and absolutely trounce him in a straight up 1v1, which proves Frost Firejacket Odinson is the best shot, unlike the Chosen Alien Hunter. With the mission complete, we get back to base and Frost gets promoted and we decide to go with Steady Hands, so if we don't move we get plus 10 aim and plus 10 crit. Not a bad ability and definitely a good passive, we'll take what we can get. We also get the Shadow Keeper research at the Proving Grounds and also begin Plated Armor research to help out armor troubles. We go for the Black Site mission as well on the world map and get our new piece of kit, the Shadow Keeper. In the Black Site mission, our first opponent is a mech who we shoot for heavy damage. It decides to return the favor but misses and gets made into nuts and bolts thanks to our return fire. The trooper is unfortunate as he misses too, and we give him a 1-2 punch as we counter, and then when it's our turn we use the Shadow Keeper to conceal ourselves and stop the Chosen Assassin from hunting us down. After we scout around, we get a quick cutscene, we set to a proper scouting routine, and we even get to the back of the black site as we see the assassin at the back of the facility, which is just simply hilarious. We're also being followed as well, and we just find an entrance and head on in. We find exactly what we're looking for, which is the black site vial, which we'll need later. all of the security outside is now looking for us, which is definitely not a good thing. So when we move outside, the Vipers miss their grabs, but we sprint to the evac zone as we don't need to fight. We just need to get out of here. So we do exactly that. Frost only suffers one day of wounds, almost like avoiding fighting is a good thing to avoid injury, but more importantly, the Avatar project has been slowed down. Mr. X gives our monthly report, and my word, it's just a paragraph of events. It's simply excellent to see. Mr. X has a mission for us, and there's really isn't a lot to say other than we had a Muton and a Lancer. The Lancer misses and gets returned fire, and we one-shot the Muton. The Lancer gets hit on us for 2 HP, but it cost it its usefulness and allowing us to complete the mission no problem. So short and sweet, and I just wish all missions could be like this. We decide to expand our facility and Gorilla Ops hits us in the face once again. We can counter an event and get a much needed engineer whilst having a decent objective, so sign us up. We are very sneaky as we walk around and patrols walk past us and don't notice. We eventually get some Vipers and we manage to one-shot one with our sniper. The remaining two close in on us and use their turn to move into position. We use our pistol twice thanks to Lightning Hands doing enough damage to weaken it, and then we finish up with a Shadowfall, reconcealing ourselves, buying us another turn. However, when we move in, the Viper isn't there, and we do spot a cluster of enemies, and we use Lightning Hands to take the Trooper down a peg. We use Face Off to chip all the health bars away, and the Flame Trooper uses its tools on us. It doesn't really do anything, however. The Priest tries to mind control us, but forgets we have a mind shield. Once it's our turn, we one-shot the Flame Trooper with a Sniper, which is one less body to deal with. We have no one around, so we let our abilities come off cooldown, and upon taking cover, we see everyone gathered up. A Flamer Boy decides to take a shot at us, but it does nothing once again, and we retaliate with a double whammy, putting the guy down. Simply lovely. The Priest is an idiot and manages to miss us, but we return fire, and then it's just the Spectre left. So we go around the corner, and the camera ominously pans over, so we move on over there, and sure enough, the Spectre is there. We pop a cap in it, winning us the mission. Russ is tired, so no covert ops for him. He's out for 11 days, which isn't ideal, but we do get plated armored research and the chosen sabotage out unused weapon slots, which isn't awful, but we get more regions contacted, and we do get dragon rounds, which do plus one damage, and have a chance of setting fire to enemies, which is very powerful. We also get the South American content bonus. We get a radio beacon built, so we have a chance to get a soldier join us in battle, which we can't use as per the rules. A retaliation mission pops up and we have resistance forces assisting us. They help out by taking berserkers down, and we help by sniping it into the ground. The resistance are pinned by mutons, and we do damage another berserker a little with lightning and use our sniper to really damage them. The resistance put in work, killing both mutons with regular assault rifles, which is brilliant. Makes the mission so much easier, and we kill the second berserker with a sniper shot. The resistance just start racking up kills against the aliens, really doing the heavy lifting here, and the aliens don't even go for us, they go for the civilians. We kill a Muton and damage the berserker. The Muton tries to melee us, but we're fine, nothing happens. The resistance just keep taking the aliens down with little to no issues, and we snipe our final berserker and a faceless spawns, which is fair enough, I guess. We simply pistol shoot it, ending the mission. Gotta be honest, yeah, the resistance kind of did the heavy lifting in that mission. Russ needs to rest as he is tired, so no covert ops for him. So we decide to hit a facility in the meantime and really stick it to the aliens. When the mission starts, it isn't too bad. That is until we see the Berserker Queen, and we just simply run the other way as fast as possible. However, we do get hit by the Berserker Queen, but we don't get dazed, so we sprint away and get to the next area to plant the charges. We wait and nothing pressing happens, so we run to the front door and just evac out. The Doomsday Project is stopped, the Legion won't win yet as we still have a hero's journey to begin. We get Mr. X's monthly report and the Chosen are getting stronger, which is quite worrying. We build a power relay on an exposed power coil we've excavated, and we also start doing covert ops with Frost. It's only 4 days and we'll boost his mobility by +1, so it'll help hugely. We get some nice things from the black market and we have Frost come back from ops. We get plasma rifles started since we got Illyrium from the black market, and our power relay gets an Illyrium conduit tacked on, as well as a power conduit, solving our power troubles. We then begin building the training center and replace our original power coil with a guerrilla tactics school. It's time for more guerrilla ops, and we outfit Frost's rifle with a hair trigger and get to the operation. We make our way to the transport, which is standard, as we spot an officer, so lightning them, as we are Frass Odinson after all. We do mind the damage, and next up is the Lancers, who just get one-shotted, which is just excellent, as Frass is simply awesome. The Chosen Warlock then decides to show up. Long time no see. Last I heard, they got swarmed by our friends, the Lost. We go ahead and move on over to the truck, ready for next turn. However, the Chosen Warlock decides to summon Spectral Zombies against us. Once we see the zombies, we decide to take a step back and start clearing them like the Lost. Anywho, we finish off the summons and we use the Shadowkeeper ability Shadowfall to reconceal ourselves. Once we find the Warlock, we spite him and use Lightning Hand and just run. The Warlock and his Spectral Henchmen try to corner us, but we head to the roof and use Face Off, devastating them as it hits them all in glorious fashion. The Warlock tries to mind control us and he didn't get the memo, so it doesn't work. So we head to the other side of the building and we shoot him full of holes yet again as he doesn't learn, and Frass is doing the complete opposite. The Warlock decides to throw more bodies at us by creating a Spectral Army, but once again he underestimates us. Whilst he may be immune to bullets, we whittle his army down with little to no trouble. Our abilities come off cooldown and they're easily dealt with, and the Warlock questions why mind control isn't working, so tries once again. Surprise, surprise, it doesn't work, so we make sure to snipe him out of the battlefield, winning once again, which is amazing. We get back to the mission now and we find an Archon. We decide to leg it and head round the corner out of sight. But once the Archon sees us again, we decide to get some distance and try to do as much damage as possible. He misses his melee thankfully, which is great, and he gets a counter with return fire, which allows us to double tap the Archon on our turn, which is a big problem taking care of. A Mouton, however, does get a hit on us for half of our health. We go to full cover and clip him with a shot. And then the Mouton gets closer and overwatches. However, we snipe his buddy with an excellent shot, and in anger, the Mouton tries to melee us but misses. We get a two tap on him, finishing another encounter with the Chosen. Back at base, Frost gets his final promotion. In this run, we go ahead and get Fanfire, so we can attack three times in a row with our pistol for one action. A very deadly ability indeed, and a staple for us with tough enemies. It also combines very nicely with Quick Draw. We start scanning on the world map and we get a free engineer, which is always nice. Dark Event is also countered, which is nice, but then we get the big turning point for this run, which is we get the training center online. This is where Frass goes above promotion, as we can get all the abilities on screen. So the first ability we get is Serial. So every time we kill an enemy with our sniper, we get our action refunded. A very powerful ability, especially with Fanfire, giving the best of both worlds. We also have extra abilities outside of the sharpshooter tree, one of which is Run and Gun. So we can take an action after dashing, which is the same ability as the Ranger class gets. A very powerful ability, proving Frass is the descendant of Jorgen, our enemy within soldier, who was an absolute powerhouse. We go even further and get Shadow Step, which is a passive ability which allows us to no longer trigger Overwatch or Reaction Fire, really turning up the ante. We're still not done, as we upgrade our Soldier Bond to level 2 between Batman and Alfred. The only usable benefit is the Covert Ops will take one less day, but that alone is extremely useful. So we go ahead and we have to pass on a few missions, including a supply raid, which isn't great, but the Gorilla Training School finishes, so we decide to get Deadshot, giving plus 10 crit chance to Frass. We send Frass on Ops to reduce the Avatar progress and get plus 1 health, which is great. All is good until we get Ambush, which is not ideal. However, this is why we paired Frass with a Reaper, as the Reaper won't trigger any enemy fire, so we can safely use the Reaper without breaking the rules. We get Frass critting a Flame Trooper and we activate Gun and Run, so we can get to high cover and Overwatch with our Sniper. We unfortunately miss, however, the enemy misses too, and Alfred manages to get to the evac point no problem, and Frass follows. We succeeded by a large margin, as the Avatar project is reduced by 2 and Frass gets more help, and Alfred is promoted, which is always good. We also give Frass a combat stim, giving him plus 22 dodge to minimize damage, which is just absolutely fantastic. We then begin the hunt for the Chosen, as we need to try and take them out of action permanently. So we assign an ops team to start tracking the Chosen Hunter, and whilst that's underway, Frass does a resistant mission for the Templars. It's all fine and dandy until we get surrounded by the Lost and we take some damage, which is fair. We start shooting against more of the Lost by the dozen, as it is getting quite difficult. However, we get to the VIP and we get on top of a container and use Face Off to hit everyone, which is brilliant. However, all the damage is nice, but a Lost does manage to jab us and say stop that. So we run as fast as we can away from the Lost and we chain together many kills and we run and gun on through. Vanfire destroys a tanky zombie, and Run and Gun allows us to reload our sniper. We use Cereal to wipe out two zombies, one after the other, whilst moving the full distance next turn. We managed to save ourselves, and thank goodness we did. When we get back to the Avenger, the plasma rifle research is completed, allowing us to get the powered Shadowkeep, and we decide to construct a lab for more research breakthroughs. We upgrade the resistance comms and staff an engineer there. We get the plasma lance research started so we can have tier 3 snipers very soon. We pass on Guerrilla Ops, but it's no sweat as we finish building the defense matrix, which will help out. Our covert ops comes back and our main man has plus 6 dodge, which is very good. So we have him do another operation for 3 days and a mission comes up, but we have to pass on it. It's a shame as it's a supply raid, but oh well. Frass comes back and now he has plus 1 mobility, very useful against the Hunter, and speaking of which, we get to locate in the Hunter to start taking the Chosen out. A bunch of dark events happens, which isn't too bad all things considered, and our Plasma Lance research is complete. So we get the defense matrix online and staffed in case the worst happens, and we skip another round of Guerrilla Ops and make contact with another region. We purchase a plasma rifle, so we're up to tier 3 weaponry. More covert ops and one of our soldiers is captured. Thankfully it wasn't Frass, otherwise it would have been game over. Once we're in the new region, we target the facility and arm Frass to the teeth, and we have a sniper with a double clip size. Jesus man, are you really prepping for this? We get Frass on the map and due to better movement, we get to the base easily. Turn 3, we see the Viper King, but plant the charger no problem, and the Viper King gets the Odinson Lightning. We then evac out, no problem, a very short and easy time. We reset the Doomsday counter with only 2 days to spare, which was a extremely close call. After we finish several covert ops missions, we gain access to the Hunter's Stronghold, so we go ahead and assault the facility. Quite frankly, I don't know what to expect, but it'll be very difficult, that's for sure. Anyway, upon entering the facility, we see 4 blimming chrysalids, and very soon it's 3 chrysalids, and Lady Luck is on our side as we don't get hit in melee from them. Dastardly fellows, we fall back and use Shadow Fall to go invisible, grant us 1 extra turn and 1 less chrysalid. We get them closing in and they see us, but nothing happens, so we kill 1 more of the pesky fellows and it's up to chance if the last one hits us. So fingers crossed and the XCOM gods reward us as it misses us so we can easily dispatch it and take it out. We go to the next room and it's 4 more of the 4-legged nightmares, but we activate Zero and plink away the chrysalids, and the first 2 are killed no problem, which is awesome. The 3rd gets lightning hands as a free attack and then we take them down, and as for the last one, we fanfire and they all get owned in 1 turn. We wait around for a while until our abilities are off cooldown and we fanfire the shield bearer. It unfortunately doesn't die, but when it's the alien's turn, they can't hit for squat, which is hilarious. Eventually, they don't really pose a threat to us as we just wreck them and it's really, really easy. So we then step onto the lift and we get a prompt to say if we're ready, and we're as ready as we can be, so we go ahead and confirm. The Legion of Dune Hunter comes in and he doesn't learn his lesson, so we go ahead and show him how it's done. He opens with a trank shot, doesn't really affect us. We return the favour by using our pistol for a little bit of damage. We also use Cereal to kill a troop outright, which is hilarious, and we decide the Hunter needs lightning, so a extra pistol shot goes his way for good measure. We also shoot him with a sniper, so he's only on 1 HP. We get people shoot us, but the Hunter decides he wants to use a grenade to force us back a little, which... okay, I guess. On our turn, we run and gun to snipe the Lancer. Next turn, we set up and use Face Off, doing excellent damage, removing lots of threats on the battlefield. The Hunter damages us with an attack, which is to be expected, and we return the favor to kill him, but it's not over yet. Units are summoned in. Thankfully, it's only an officer and a spectre, so it could be worse, but we start to attack the sarcophagus, which will resurrect the Hunter. So we try to maximize our damage as much as possible. When the phase is over, the Hunter does return on full health. So we immediately get to high ground, though we spot the dastardly fellow, then attack with our pistol. We also use lightning hands to add some more hurt and finish with another pistol shot, so 3 attacks. A poor man's fire, if you will. The Hunter grapple hooks and trank shots us like an idiot as we're immune. When it's our turn, we get near the sarcophagus and we wait for our moment, and our Overwatch shot kills the Hunter, which is good. We get a Berserker, which is not good, and a Chrysalid. While certainly bad, it could get worse. We injure the Chrysalid and then go for the artifact to destroy it. Insect Boy tries to melee us but misses, and we return fire, killing the little gnat. We get high ground and we use our shot to destroy the hunter's trick to keep respawning. The berserker misses its strike, so we return fire, giving us a fighting chance. We tactically get out and take full cover whilst kiting the berserker. We then fanfire the berserker, killing it outright, and the chosen gets a pistol round. In response, the hunter decides to close the gap and uses a trank shot, doing nothing. We shoot the hunter, doing the same damage, and we use one last tap to put him out of business. So the Legion of Doom have lost a member to the Forces of Justice, and the cutscene is just awesome. Once we're back at base, we get the most powerful weaponry in the game, and now all we need to do is research it. So now, go get it researched. Legion of Doom have a meeting about their defeat. They're not happy about our guy on his way to becoming a hero. The Warlock is a melon, as his most recent training is hard countered by Shadow Step, so well done, Warlock. The assassin is close to finding our whereabouts, so probably should hunt her down next. We get resistance orders and gain a cheeky bonus from the skirmishers that improves our weapon modifications. Not bad. Not bad at all. We replace our current bonus with Trial by Fire, so we get double ability points in combat as well. We also complete our research, getting us the Dark Lance and the Dark Claw. And last but not least, we also get the Predator Armor, so we can have two items in battle now, which is absolutely brilliant. We get the perfect opportunity to test these lovely little things out in a council mission of all things. In the council mission, we actually find the Viper King as he decides to show up. We kill his Viper friend, and well, the results speak for themselves. We use a lightning for a bill of damage and go nuts by using Fanfire to do really chaotic damage. The Viper King just says no and decides he wants to teleport out, so once Frost returns from an operation, getting more mobility, we go to the training grounds and we get the ability Deadeye, so we take a small aim penalty for a significant damage boost to our sniper, which is very good for our combos, and also punching through armor. We also get covering fire, so our Overwatch shots now trigger not only on shots, but on actions as well. Very good for defensive play. We get a council mission, and it's kind of an odd one as we easily get past the enemy with our high mobility, and by turn 3, we're already across the map, and we get outside the cell, but Frost panics, which isn't great. However, the enemy use a flamethrower to release the VIP, which is interesting, I guess. So thank you, kind flame trooper. Anyway, we get Frost kicking their butt so royally that they can't do anything in return to us. It's just simply so wonderful. So we go ahead and evac everyone out, which is just brilliant. The Shadow Chamber is up and running, so we can now see what we're up against, helping what rounds we want to use for the mission. We can view our opponents in the Guerrilla Ops missions, and we also have a sitrep that allows us to see the map. So once we evac the resistance soldier given to us by the Volunteer Army, regional bonus, we get to business. We activate Serial, and we manage to take the Mutons out, no problem, one by one, which is always good. For Scuba Alien, we lightning hands them and go for Deadeye to punch through the armor, dealing a large amount of damage. However, it closes in on us and manages to try to melee us, but misses, which is a sigh of relief. We use our pistol to shut the thing down and then run and gun to a higher ledge to utilize death from above, as we can't use Serial in the same turn. We use run and gun. We can use death from above to compensate, and we one-shot the shield bearer, which is lovely, and we fanfire the Archon to really send the message home. We go on Overwatch and the Viper King is back, and we do miss our shot. However, once everyone's moved, we lightning a Viper and decide to get up on a ledge and begin using our sniper to devastate an effect, as death from above procs, allowing for chain kills, really doing absurd damage, and the Viper King gets his farewell. We give him a salute and we kill the last soldier to complete the mission. That sitrep made this the easiest mission to date, period. We research the Viper King suit and our covert ops is launched, so we can get +1 resistance contact. Once research is complete, we unlock the suit in the Proving Ground and we get the best breakthrough, which is +1 damage to pistols, which is so good for us. Our covert ops were successful and Alfred gets promoted, which is good. The pistol research is completed, so our pistols now deal +1 damage, which is fantastic, and we also pass on a retaliation mission as Frass is on covert ops. However, we get ambushed, which isn't ideal, so as per the rules, our operatives are not allowed to help us. Mission plays out fairly safe. We have a couple of scuba aliens, but Frost deals with them no problem. We even get a scuba alien just outside the evac zone, and we manage to destroy it in its entirety. We do get the loss, and our pistol destroys them very rapidly, so we don't have to worry, and we carry on running. Eventually, though, we do evac everyone out until it's just Frost, and shortly thereafter, he gets out as well, so jobs are good. And We get Alfred and Cyborg on another operation for a stack of ability points to help Fress out. So we just get researching the autopsies in the meantime until they're back with the good news. We go straight to the training center and we decide to unlock Killzone. Very similar to the Chosen Hunter's ability where we can lock down an area. Very good for restricting the enemy, adding lots of lethal potential. Guardian is also something that we get, so our Overwatch shots have a 50% chance of shooting a second Overwatch shot. Very good for defensive play, although limited by our ammo. And lastly, we go for Long Watch. Not that it matters, but our Overwatch applies to squad sight. Not that we'll be using it much, but for missions with VIPs, we could get some limited use out of it. We then get to test out Killzone on a Gorilla Op as we plop down an area similar to the Hunter Chosen but do it better as we get a shot on every single enemy as they want to attack us. We manage to kill not one but two enemies with two shots and our final shot injures the trooper. When it's our turn we use a pistol to kill the trooper and we then get to meet the Chosen Warlock. He tries to mind control us but still hasn't learnt that it won't work on us and one of the zombies does get an attack on us but the rest wish to detonate but face off is perfect to clear the field of minions. And then it's the Warlock's turn. He fires his gun at us, but when it's our turn, we use the Odinson Lightning on him and then use Serial to kill the last zombie and fanfire the Chosen, winning us the mission no problem. Back at base, we get Frost's final ability, which is great. However, it doesn't really do much, then offer plus 20 aim next turn after we've hunkered down. Whilst not amazing, it is better than nothing, so we take it. Now we've got all of our abilities, which is what we've been striving for all this time. Now it's time to take the fight to the Chosen, so we just need to find the Assassin. Unfortunately, the Assassin finds us first and attacks the Avenger. With this mission, we can lose all of our progress, so this is going to be a very stressful mission. The cutscene plays and Bradford saying we have to defend this ship with everything we can. We decide to get the Viper King armor on Frass as it gets extra dodge and we can even freeze the Assassin if necessary. We deploy on in and get Frass in position. We use Killzone after using Lightning Hand so we can lock down a position just in case the Assassin comes charging in. We do kill an officer, which is something, but a lance comes in and puts our plan out of action as they get some damage on us. The heavy mech gets a volley on two of our turrets. We manage to hit the mech with a turret as well as the lancer. Frost moves forwards and takes a chunk out of the Archon's health and our turret gets a lucky shot on it. We then get to utilise Death from Above on a Mouton, netting a free kill and use Lightning Hands and Face Off combo to kill an enemy and spread the damage around. We utilise our turret squad sight to destroy one of the siege buggies, which is awesome. We go ahead and use Serial to scout near the buggies as the aliens are almost definitely going to be present. And we were right. So the Lancers get some and the Flame Trooper is also done with a good shot and the mech gets dead-eyed. We get a crit and fanfire the Archon, but it still lives, which is fair enough. The Archon does hit us, but dodge makes us only take 3 damage. We try our luck with the turret and land a low hit chance, killing Flyboy, and we advance forwards, only to find more forces, which isn't great, but to be expected. We get shot at, but nothing happens until the sector pod uses its Wrath Cannon. When it's our turn, we get out the area and use Lightning Hands on the mech and place Killzone down. We get a hit on the trooper, but miss the second shot, but the mech is put out of business, which is great. We shoot the sector pod twice with our pistol. The enemy takes some shots at us, but they miss, which costs them dearly, as we shoot the trooper, making them explode, and use Deadeye on the sector pod, destroying it, allowing us to begin targeting the generator. So we go ahead and destroy it, which is superb. Our turrets get Overwatch shots off on the enemy. We decide to perch ourselves on a ledge and do heavy damage against the alien siege buggy, and with a bill of sniping, we also use one of our turrets to destroy the siege buggy like we did earlier, as it's a decent way to get rid of them. We grapple hook over and rinse and repeat. Now we go and look for the Assassin and they are right on our doorstep next to our turrets. Although our turrets aren't great shots by any means, they do remove the cover and we start really damaging the Assassin. We use the old reliable Lightning Hands and then use the Viper King's armor's special ability to freeze the Assassin in place. We fanfire to deal more damage and our turret does the honors and we beat back the villain. We clear up the alien force in the area, including a gatekeeper, which isn't too bad as we have fanfire and a pistol that ignores armor, so it's no sweat. We then search forever to find the last enemy, which is the Spectre, and as it turns out, it's hiding, which was super annoying, but we snipe it and use a turret to send it packing. A stressful mission, but we completed it. After we complete the mission, all we need to do is locate the Assassin's stronghold. So after a few covert ops, we managed to get the mission unlocked to go and face the Assassin on their home turf. This mission, This one mission was the biggest pain this run. Now, as per the rules, if I fail, I can try again, but only from the start of the Stronghold selection screen. So let's go ahead and dive into it. Get into the Stronghold and we get a welcoming party as the Legion of Doom want us dead. So we do the serial lightning combo and kill the mech, no issues. The officer is put down and we wait around and let our abilities come off cooldown and progress further into the fortress. We see the Lancer and use lightning and shut the door and use Killzone from a distance to play it safe. We miss the officer, but we do kill the Lancer, which is good news for us as that was our intended target. We switch to our pistol and kill the officer no problem, and the enemy lurk around and we get an Overwatch shot that kills a Mouton. Here we take cover and we blast away the cover and bam fire to kill Alien Bioshock. They decide to come in close, but a pistol shot and a snipe later, they're out with the trash. We quickly get to the lift and more personnel are here. We just use lightning hand and run and gun to get out of a sticky jam. We use Deadeye to hurt the Archon and we get a lot of projectiles thrown our way and they miss, which is simply excellent for us. We fanfire the Lancer as he is a melee unit and we decide to use Face Off to damage everything. The enemy don't really have good aim, so can't really respond, so we make a response for them with Serial to mop them up, and we take them all down. We get to the lift and it gives us a prompt and we pray that we're ready for the assassin. Upon entering, we immediately go to high cover and the alien security is present. They are quite unlucky as we can just straight up take them out no problem. They're not exactly that tough. So then we have the guest of honor show up. The assassin decides they can attack us and we get dazed. I totally forgot to equip the mind shield, so that'd be attempt one. Six attempts later of doing the fortress and getting back here, we change it up for the Viker King armor, which gives more survival. The assassin manages to hit us and summon some friends and run away. So we chase the assassin down and activate Serial to kill the faceless ones. A bullet for each of them and we go for fanfire against the assassin for some hefty damage, but we get blinded with a grenade. But we still manage to get two shots off on them and the assassin runs away. So we decide to use Overwatch in response and the Chosen uses a wave attack on us, but it doesn't really do anything, it just knocks us over thanks to Mind Shield. We use our pistol to kill the assassin, however, we grapple hook over next to the sarcophagus and we unload as much as we can into it. We use as many abilities as physically possible in two volleys and the sarcophagus falls. Now all we have to do is deal with the assassin. We cautiously move around, the assassin gets a swipe on us, but it's one turn too late as we use lightning hands and fanfire to finish off the assassin, letting us breathe as seventh time lucky. Thank you. We get the death scene and salute Deathstroke from the Legion of Doom, as she was a worthy adversary. Back at base, Thrass is out for 15 days, but it's fine, as that was easily the most difficult fight thus far, but it's okay as it's all done now, so all is good. It's time we set our sights on the last Chosen so we can breathe easy and halt the Avatar project. We get the Covert Ops team to locate the Warlock, however we get Thrass up and running by revitalizing him. We can only do this once per game per soldier, and since Thrass is our own soldier, we can only do this once. So we pay the one Illyrian core and go strike a facility so the Doomsday counter doesn't hit zero to make us lose the game. The facility mission is easy as we avoid detection, we get close enough to place the charges, we stupidly shoot a Mouton which causes a hole in the wall where everyone can pour on in and they all decide to come in. The Berserker Queen even socks us for being a fool, which we kind of deserve honestly, but a Mouton flanks us and does decent damage. Well played, sir. However, we've already placed the charges, so we fanfire the Berserker Queen and immediately evac out, so it's all clear. Mission success. Quite a close one, actually. We finish the assassin's weaponry, not what we need, but it makes for a nice collector's item, I guess. Grillorps is out of the question as Thrass is out for 10 days and we get sabotaged by the Warlock where research will take 7 days longer, but joke's on him as we pretty much finished all the research. We also finish a second power relay, so power is no longer a concern, and we also see Bradford on a treadmill at 5:40 in the morning. You go, Bradford, you determined bloke, you. We get Mr. X's monthly report, and there are some hiccups, but all in all, things are going okay. Anywho, we get North America reclaimed, and after getting 9 credits, we get our ops team to locate the final Chosen, we get the Skulljack started to get the story sorted. We also pass on a mission from Mr. X, which isn't wise, as it's Mr. X. But unfortunately, we get ambushed and it's not great. So upon deployment, we get everyone inside a building. We get Frost taken out a trooper, which is great. But Frost gets shot by an officer, which he just shrugs off like a champ. We run like hell to the evac point and meet a Mouton who gets one shot, and a scuba alien goes for the loss, which is fair enough. We just begin evacing everyone out, which is excellent, and we clear the mission. Frost is out of action, so it's off to the Templar HQ to heal a little bit faster, but the Warlock decides to be a copycat and attack the Avenger. With this mission, we're allowed to bring in wounded soldiers, and since we only have Frost, he's going to be the one we deploy. But Bradford will reinforce us with troops from the ship, however they won't be allowed to participate in the mission. But once we deploy, I'll just spare you all the trouble of how it went, as we already had the assassin attack the ship earlier, and it plays pretty much the same. Back at base, we focus on locating the Last Chosen. We have to skip on several missions to our detriment, as Frass is injured, but it's more important to locate the Chosen. We also get plus one resistance contact from a scan, always nice. It's now the moment I've been waiting for, the final stronghold, and we set for our mission and we go on in. I'll be honest, I didn't think we'll get this far when we started the playthrough, but here we are, the final stronghold. We step on in and get to it immediately. We find a fly guy and lightning and snipe them out of existence. We also fan fire scuba alien, as well as taking them down to 1 HP. They approach us, they don't hit us, so we manage to two tap them with our pistol, which is brilliant. Get moving through the fortress and we cautiously take cover and overwatch our rifle. It misses, but our stock does guarantee us some damage, and since we overwatch the enemy during their turn, it's our move. So we decide to use Serial and one-shot the first enemy trooper, always a nice opener. We use lightning to detonate an explosive barrel, which removes cover and allows us to shoot down the officer, killing him outright. And lastly, we dead-eye the flame trooper, so with that, everyone is dead and jobs are good. And as we explore more, we see a bunch of specters and an Archon. We run and gun to pistol shoot a specter. The Archon isn't impressed, but he misses his melee, but the specter is quite skilled and gets a damaging shot off against us. We fan fire against the Archon, putting him down, and the specter also gets shown what for. There are still specters in the area, so we do have to be careful. The final room has a few enemies, so we cause lots of chaos by making the flame trooper explode and leave everyone dead on the ground. We get to the Warlock's inner sanctum and we get to take out a Lancer as well as an officer, no problem. So we get to the cutscene and it's clear he's consumed by his own power, which is very typical of villains in general. When the Warlock is here, we decide to shoot him in the face to show we're here. The Warlock decides to summon two mechs. Like a fool, he tries to mind control us, which doesn't work. In response, we lightning and Serial as a combo to destroy one of the mechs entirely. We use Deadeye to destroy the other, and we decide to get up high and shoot the Warlock, who takes extra damage due to the brittle weakness. The Warlock decides to back off and summon a Spectral Army, which is always annoying as he has a shield. But on our turn, we return to the Warlock and lay down Killzone, which damages a fair few Spectral soldiers. Once that is done, we back up and wait for them. One by one, the enemy come on in and we overwatch one of them. They get a chance to hit us, but they all miss one after the other. Like, I know you ghost guys, but come on, seriously. We show them the error of their ways and we use face off and we kill all of them in one turn. The Chosen is adamant about his mind control and overwatches us, allowing us to flip a coin to snipe him in the face. We do so and he teleports away and summons more lancers, which is quite the annoying ability. So we use our pistol and then use Serial to excellent effect and Deadeye the last answer and run and gun and shoot the Warlock in his grave. So his sarcophagus is then revealed to us, but so many things get summoned, so we kind of have to kill the chrysalid and fanfire the sarcophagus. The enemy are dealt with accordingly as we take cover and try to do as much damage as we can against the sarcophagus. A couple of snipe shots and it's damaged, but not out of commission, meaning we have to fight the Chosen for round two at full strength. But we do have a plan this time, and the Warlock gets hit from us for 6 damage and teleports away. He then decides to open fire on us, which ultimately misses, so we decide to use Deadeye to inflict even more damage. However, the Chosen decides to use Spectral Army again and summons lots of lancers. So we decide to run and use our mobility and give them a runaround. We break line of sight and eventually the Spectral Army disappears. The Warlock is now vulnerable again, so we set up next to the Chosen, risking being shot. However, he goes for a mind control so we can go ahead and use Deadeye for ridiculous damage, which would just about one-shot the Chosen on full health. But this makes the sarcophagus phase again begin, so we move forwards and use Lightning on the Chrysalid and use Face Off to get rid of the Insect Boy, and we deal damage to everyone. The aliens don't do much, and on our next turn we use Fanfire to destroy the artifact. We reload our sniper, ready for the Chosen, and when the Chosen does reappear, we use Serial and kill the officer, chipping another enemy away. We Deadeye the Warlock, he's still alive and does one final Spectre army, which is super annoying. So once again, we get our running shoes on and start moving around. A Lancer does actually land a strike on us, bringing us down to 1 HP, which is terrifying. So we go ahead and keep running and use Face Off to stop a Spectre in their tracks. However, the Warlock tries to be smart and teleports a unit on our flank and moves to try and get us, but we use Fanfire to wipe out the last of the Legion of Doom, and a Death Scene plays, which is nice, as no more Legion interfering with us, which is good. Frost is out for 11 days, but there's no Chosen to bother us anymore, so we can finally relax. But we get amazing news as we get +1 damage with beam weapons, which is simply amazing, especially against 10 HP enemies. We research the Warlock weaponry because we get the Disruptor Rifle, a interesting bit of kit, and definitely want to do a run with this in future. This thing is pretty cool. Anyway, we go to the Templar's HQ once more to get Frost on his feet ASAP, and we have to pass on Guerrilla Ops, but once Frost is better, we get a operation for one of our operatives that get captured earlier. We decide that no one gets left behind, so send Frost in to go and get them. We get Frost searching the area's perimeter and find a doorway to the VIP cell. And once we get closer, we decide to hack the door, and Frost gets a permanent +20 to his hacking ability, which is always nice and certainly very, very welcome. But the downside is the alarm is tripped, so we lightning the trooper and we fanfire the Archon, killing him outright. We grab our friend, the enemy shoot us for a little bit, but we get to the evac zone and we rescue our friend. Hooray! With our friend safe and sound, we reveal him to be Ollie Queen. Oliver Queen doesn't quite fit by one letter, but I'm sure he won't mind being called Ollie for short. Welcome to the covert team, sir. We do some covert ops to reduce the Avatar's progress, so we go ahead, and when they come on back, Frass has increased health, and the Avatar project is reduced, saving us from the Doomsday counter. At this stage of the game, we want to boost Frost's stats through the roof, so we have to keep sending him out on covert ops whilst keeping the Avatar project down with ops. So we just keep farming stats for him via ops, and we even pass on any guerrilla ops or optional missions to keep the covert ops going and focus on Frost's training. We eventually get the Doomsday counter back up, and we decide to counter the UFO Dark Event as the admin ship has been attacked enough this playthrough. But we check Frost's stats before we deploy, and we have 59 dodge, 131 aim, 16 mobility, and yeah, these stats are very good, so it'll only get better from here on out. Anyway, we deploy and we immediately get to work. So when we see the enemy, we use Serial to kill any troopers without fail. We scale the roof to utilize Death from Above and take out a lot of enemy troopers, and we Deadeye the officer, so he dead. We get to the truck and hack the objective so we don't have to worry about the timer, and we do get hit by a rude gatekeeper from an area of effect attack, and we also get shot, but our high dodge reduces the damage taken, but we still get hit nonetheless. We use Serial to kill the trooper, and we fanfire the gatekeeper, finishing him off and completing our mission. Frost has 333 kills. Bloody hell, man, you are literally a one-man army. You've got the spirit of a Viking Spartan in you. That's just amazing. We get back to Frost's training and begin expanding and building radio beacons. The ops keeps the Avatar project down, we get some beacons up and running, and we start moving into Africa to hone in on one of the facilities whilst Frost is training. We get to the facility and use Frost to take it down, so we quickly deploy on in and we move on in to the base very rapidly with our movement. It is just ridiculously fast. We jimmy the door and a sector pod shows up. It uses lightning field to damage us, but everyone else just misses their shots against us, which is awesome. On our turn, we decide to go ahead and set the charges, we call in the Sky Ranger, and we get out of dodge. So, all is good, which stops the Doomsday counter once again. We begin research on the Black Site file to finally get the main story underway, and we get a cutscene and find out that the aliens really are up to no good. We get a council mission and we decide to take the Skulljack with us, and the mission goes as standard. As we see Mutons, we decide to kill them, we lighten the Spectre, we use Deadeye to finish it off, we Overwatch, and we manage to hit a mech. The aliens take cover, we shoot the mech, killing it, and we do heavy damage to the Flame Trooper. Mr. Gatekeeper uses ghost energy to try and summon many more bodies, but we fanfire on the Gatekeeper, putting an end to them. We shoot the Trooper and it's all good. We get to a building looking for an officer to use the skulljack in. We see our mark, he shoots us and we get grazed due to our dodge. The Lancer misses us and then when it's our turn we manage to kill the Lancer, which is no problem. We use Serial to give the good old snipe to a trooper and finally we get what we're after as we use the skulljack on the officer. Once the officer is skulljacked, we have a Codex show up and he uses a psionic bomb against us. So we just go ahead and use Fanfire against it, just taking it out almost immediately. Once that's cleared up, we hack the door and we manage to get a 50% faster scan on the world map, which is just lovely. So we get the go ahead and get out of dodge with a bunch of loot, which is excellent. We even have a Codex Brain amongst our loot, which is exactly what we need, and we also get the Avatar Project decrease, which is excellent. And to add to that, our Covert Ops also reduce the Avatar Project as well, so we almost immediately get to researching the Codex Brain. I'm convinced Tigan is a mad scientist, so best make him a cup of tea when he wants it. For us, it's back to training again, and we also get the Codex cutscene, so we begin the encrypted Codex research and keep expanding our regions. Soon enough, we get the next cutscene, and we have to skulljack a Codex. Once the cursor scene concludes, we get the final region of Africa, allowing us to gain instant contact with new regions, which is super helpful. We eventually get Frost back from Covert Ops, and he's ready. His stats are insanely good, he's got the tools for the job, so we decide to send him out on a mission. Once in the mission, we find 3 Codexes, so we dead-eye the first to kill them outright, not give them a chance. The second is Fanfire, doing much the same, and the last one we skulljack, which is pretty cool. Once we're done, we get an Avatar, and we decide to pop in and say hello. So, hello there, Mr. Avatar. The Archon King is also present, so we lightning the Avatar, then fall back with our high mobility. The Archon is taken out, and we get sniped the Avatar for a crit, and the Avatar hits us with psionic damage. But he isn't the smartest, as he's now out in the open, so we fanfire him, killing him almost instantly. As for the Archon King, we get into long-range combat, and we do metric tons of damage and make sure to stick to high cover and just snipe his health bar, right on down until he decides to teleport out. Finally, we get into the research facility with heavy resistance, so we take cover in the cell. It keeps us safe from most of the aliens due to high cover, and once the alien turn is over, we use our high mobility to plant the charges and just go on ahead and evac out in the same turn, which is amazing. Mr. X says that we reduced the Avatar Project by a ridiculous 5 blocks, which is seriously awesome, and it's nice to see on the world map. We can't research the Avatar Project just yet, however, as we need to research a few more projects first. So we decide to get Frost doing the Silent Gate mission to push the main story. We go ahead and deploy, so when we get into the mission, we get some chrysalids, which isn't so much fun, but we do snipe an Archon, burning it as we have equipped Dragon Rounds for this mission. The Codex uses a psionic bomb, so we move out the way and shoot the other Archon and let the bomb do the rest of the work for us, killing both the Archons. The Codex runs off and we follow it, see more units, so we do the old Serial and start doing what we do best and begin taking out the units in front of us one at a time. We explore the peaceful area and we get not one but 2 chrysalids and they attack us, but both them miss and we lightning one and snipe the other with no worries. However, once we're at the Silent Gate we get 3 chrysalids, so we start blasting them away with Serial until we run out of ammo, so we decide to lightning the Insect Boy and Fanfire to take out the Gatekeeper. We get hit again but we decide to use a point blank shot, and once the mission is over we get the gate as our loot, and Mr. X says the Avatar Project is down by 2 pips. We upgrade the Shadow Chamber with the gate and we get Gorilla Ops and ignore them as we build a radio beacon and establish contacts. We manage to get to the Black Site mission, which helps us continue the story once more. This mission we get some resistance and it goes pretty smoothly all things considered. It's not really that difficult, however once at the facility we decide to go on the roof and we see 2 Spectres and an Archon there. The Spectres are easily dispatched as we have blue screen rounds, and as for the Archon we just keep shooting it till it stops moving. When inside the facility a random soldier jumped through the window. Sorry buddy, I think you came to the wrong place. Anyway, his friends fare no better against us, and when there we decide to go ahead and open up the stasis chamber to get the stasis suit. As it pops out to say hello to Frost, we use our mobility and easily manage to get to the evac zone in one turn, because Frost is just a champ as always with high mobility. After our raid, we get a cutscene explaining the stasis suit we acquired, and it's pretty awesome as we're nearing the end of the game now. We can start the Avatar autopsy, and when we get the cutscene, we have a bit of a twist as Tiger meets the spirit of an elder. We quickly get Frost on an op to get +9 dodge, so why not? And after the op, we get a retaliation mission. It was pretty easy, and we even met the Archon King, who ended up getting a piece of our mind. He did try to escape, but he didn't fare too well, so it's all good. We then wait for the Shadow Chamber to be complete and get a cutscene of the Avatar. Tigan and Shen explain to Central that as the commander, we are the only one that can pilot the thing. But before anything else, we research the Archon King for Frost. But before anything of that nature, Mr. X lets us know that the aliens have a tower and that we're near the end. Mr. X has found out and we unlock the Network Tower mission, which is the intro to the final mission. The Archon King autopsy is complete and we unlock the Icarus armor in the Proving Ground. We go ahead and unlock it, and once Frass has recovered, it's time to hit the tower. The game warns us, but it's time to go ahead, and Frass is looking like a hero with his journey is complete. From rookie to hero, it's a fitting location as well for a pre-finale mission. We take it slow and our armor manages to panic one of the Archons, so we lightning and give a quick snipe to deal with them. It feels good to come full circle. A Viper is seen and it gets one shot, but his Bioshock body uses his laser, but it misses. We use our pistol and then dead-eye the poor chap, and we wait in Overwatch, and we catch him during his turn off guard, the poor sod. We reload and Icarus jump across the map and lay down Killzone just in case. But as we advance, another Archon gets panic and a Spectre is spotted too. We use lightning and use Serial to snipe the Spectre off the edge of the building, and we use Deadeye on the Archon, but it still stands. Although it's still panicked, we run and gun to the roof above our opponent and we get to sniping. We kill the Archon below us and then we blast the turret, and it's not seeing anything anymore, and lastly a codex is made into a pile of scrap. We decide to Icarus jump out of the way and get behind some cover. The Archon just overwatches, so we use our abilities to get 4 pistol shots in, putting him out of commission. We approach the console and hijack the Network Tower. A cutscene plays as we see our team, and then we see the Speaker get what he deserves from an angry mob, which is actually kind of brutal. But Frost is back, fit as a fiddle, and we get our final mission. Frost is looking the part and has stats to show for it as well, with 433 confirmed kills and 46 missions under his belt, which is absolutely ludicrous. It's time to step into our final mission. Bradford makes an awesome speech and we see Frost in the corridor and we enter the portal to the finale. Once in the portal, we have 2 units, which is myself, I guess, as the commander's avatar, and Frost. We'll keep myself at the start here, as we can't really assist Frost in any way, as we can't break the rules and invalidate the run. So we start off with a run and gun with Frost, and we panic an Archon with our armor. We lightning and Muton for 1 confirmed kill and snipe the second for a 2nd confirmed kill. The panicked Archon gets a fanfire as we journey further on in. We see a Sectapod and it uses its Wrath Cannon, so we get away and snipe it for some damage. A few volleys come our way and they miss, so on all accounts, due to the Stormtrooper training, we use Serial to kill not 1, not 2, but 3 units complete with a Deadeye in the Sectapod, clearing the way for us, simply exhilarating. It's more Mutons, Archons and a couple of Scoob aliens, so we get up high and we begin shooting away with decent results, denting their health bars. We pull back to kill zone, score some more fairly good hits. The aliens decide to start taking shots and we loop around and fanfire the Archon. But the aliens, however, do land some hits on us, taking a chunk of our health bar out. We then kill the Archon and run for it as lots of guns are pointed at us. The aliens decide to follow us, but we slip away. Once the aliens launch another volley, their numbers get binned out as run and gun comes in handy. The aliens start running, but we catch up to them and put an end to it. Once we stroll in some more, we get some Berserkers, but thanks to Guardian, we manage to get 3 Overwatch shots, significantly damaging the Berserkers, which is just excellent. We down both Berserkers without too much trouble as we shoot the first, lightning the second, and then maim it to kill it, so it's a double kill. Then my nemesis returns, the Sectoid, along with some Vipers and a Gatekeeper, really trying to make us fear them, but they must be dealt with. So immediately, we take care of the Gatekeeper, thanks to Deadeye doing ridiculous damage. We decide to use Face Off to pretty much hit everything on screen and take a lot of the units out by sheer damage, becoming the very definition of burst damage. The Sectoids are up to their old tricks, trying to mind control us, but it won't do them any good, as when it's our turn, we get to the roof and take the rest of the pack out, which is so lovely. One Archon remains, and once we kill it in its tracks, we get a cutscene of the Avatar, meaning we're on the home stretch now. We have to be very careful how we do this, otherwise we go back to the start of the mission. Also, we are locked in the Avatar's chambers with the alien forces, so speed and aggression is key. We spot one of the Avatars, so we lightning it, and it teleports away, so we fan fire it, killing it, adding one to the tally. Two more to go. We get some chrysalids teleporting in, so we start taking them out one by one, no problems. We do down them very easily, and we manage to keep the area clear. After killing the last chrysalid and getting a crit on the Archon with a sniper shot, we get mutons coming in, and things started getting hectic here. We one-shot the mutons no problem, and our turn ends as more units pour through the portal, along with the last Avatar. So all the Avatars are now present in the room, however the alien's turn is active, and one of the Avatars comes running towards us, giving a golden opportunity as other aliens, mainly Berserkers, also enter the room. When it's our turn, we fanfire the Avatar and we use Icarus Jump to change position. And we decide to use Face Off to net a few kills with a single action, which is absolutely fantastic for us. The aliens turn and the Berserkers are chasing after us, and most of the aliens move around and shuffle about. We see the last Avatar in front of us, so we take a shot with our pistol and the mark teleports away. So we use Lightning Hands to hit it again and it teleports again. We run and gun to get right next to it and we only do 7 damage. So I thought this was it and I'd have to do the mission again, as the Avatar can regenerate lost health and it can teleport about. But on the alien's turn, the Avatar tries to mind control us, but it fails. However, we get extra damage from an unexpected source as a gatekeeper decides to target the Elder with a psi attack, doing exactly 6 damage, just enough for us to win and play the ending cutscene, which wins us the run, answering the question, can you beat XCOM 2 War of the Chosen with a single sharpshooter? And the answer is yes. Yes, you bloody well can, and it was one flipping hell of a journey. Oh, I need to go lie down now. Okay, I'm going to go on record and say that was easily the most tense and stressful challenge I've done to date. Easily had me biting my nails at certain points, but flipping heck, what an amazing challenge. I never played War of the Chosen either, so there was a couple of new things I could have done to speed this up, few things I could have done to improve and make this video shorter, but half the fun was learning how War of the Chosen was different from vanilla XCOM 2. It really was a blast, and the loss just saved our asses in the early game, allowing us not to worry as much, but the enemy chosen were a big problem, and the assassin was by far the most challenging part, which took 7 attempts. I can safely say that was the toughest fight, and it was just, oh my days, it was very stressful. But still, we managed it thanks to taking out the hunter first and using their weaponry. It made the run so much easier, so much easier. That Dark Claw pistol, easily one of the best weapons in the game. I would also say Covert Ops is just busted once you get to a certain point, but this game is just so wonderful and I have nothing but praises for it. Anyway, for next week's challenge, we've got Fallout New Vegas with a campfire, because we've already done it with a workbench, so time to do it with a campfire. That's going to be quite interesting, and I've got a solid build for that one. And lastly, just thank you for watching. You're all amazing and wonderful people, so thank you so much, and just, you're all just amazing people. So like the video if you like the video, comment down below even if you wish to say hi or recommend something new, and subscribe if you're new. Up in the Insane Frame, thank you so much for watching. If you got to this point, you are just a true champ, and yeah, I'll see you all in the next one. Have a good day, everyone. I think I'll be making a cup of tea after this challenge. Take care, have a good one, have a lovely day, and enjoy the rest of your evening. Take care, ta-ta for now.